The legend of Stu Hart encompasses many chapters. Stuart Hart exemplified strength as a youth, battling the brutal Depression-era winters of the Canadian prairie. Stu's toughness was evident when he became a superstar grappler in the 40s, appearing in the famed Madison Square Garden. He took home the knowledge necessary to build Canada's most successful promotion, Stampede Wrestling.
I get to all of my paying fans are the ones that keep me in business, and I would like to give them a match that they prefer, you know.
Stu was honest, upfront. If Stu Hart told you he was going to do something, he did it.
Very determined man, you know, to succeed, and nothing but admiration for Stu Hart.
There was nobody like Stu Hart. He'd come out of the house, there'd be snow all over the place, he'd walk out barefoot with shorts on and a t-shirt, and it's 20 below, you know.
Stu Hart was a legend. He was a great man. He really, really helped me a lot. That actually was my first territory.
I mean, it was known all over the United States. You gotta go to Calgary if you're gonna learn the business.
It was in an abyss of the legendary Hart House, affectionately known as the Dungeon, where Stu's legend truly emerged. The highly skilled trainer imparted his intense style to some of the most famous and the most recognizable superstars of our time.
The infamous, let me see your neck. I stuck my neck in there and I just dropped my knees.
Before I know it, he had his arm behind my neck. I could barely breathe. Stu at 63 years old pretty much had me.
Despite his rough exterior, Stu was a caring and loving, proud father of 12.
Closest thing to, a godlike person in the world would be my father. He's just one of those rare human beings on the planet.
Just, you know, very high morals. You know, he didn't smoke or drink. He didn't even have a single cavity. I thought about as close to perfect as you could get.
He did so much. He really did. He raised money for so many charities. He was just so unassuming and gracious.
He was a huge, huge force in the wrestling business. Everything with my dad was wrestling. You wake him up in the middle of the night, ask him how to put a hammer lock on. It was like, damn, that was perfectly all right. Yeah.
My sons have all been, ever since they've been able to crawl, have been wrestling.
His progeny were involved in some of the most important moments in entertainment history. That impact is still evident today.
Smith and Natalya may have one of the most impressive lineages in the entire WWE.
What a life. What a truly amazing life he'd had. A great person. Not just a wrestler, but a hero and a gentleman.
Sometimes I didn't realize the magnitude or the footprint he had left. When he passed away, it was front page news for about a week every day in the paper. It seemed like the whole city was stopping to pay tribute.
When I go to the other side, that's kind of what I want, is to live the life that Stu had in the way that he touched people. Like Stu lives on because of how many people that he touched. He was a very unsung hero.
Stu Hart dedicated his life to his family and the fans. And WWE is proud to welcome him into the WWE Hall of Fame, Class of 2010.